Hello and welcome to this week's Scriptcase video. My name is Jamie and I am your host. In today's video, we will be checking out SourceGuardian and seeing how we can encrypt our project code, as well as our libraries that we have created, as well as any other applications and even files that we maybe want to protect from those, you know, pesky people that want to be viewing our data. So for that, we have encryption, okay? And with encryption, we can change what our data looks like. So to give you an idea, I'm going to be going through all of the steps that you need to actually set this up, as well as start to use it. Now, I do need to highlight the fact that SourceGuardian is a paid product, and I do not have an official license. So I'm also only using the free trial version. So with the free trial version, I am limited. I am unable to add this to my Scriptcase project, which is of course a bit of a shame, because there you can on the fly encrypt and decrypt your data, meaning your project code, the libraries that you have spent so much hard work and time creating. So ideally, in a great world, you would want to just leave them as they are. But as it is, of course, many people may want to, you know, check out the keys that you have hand-coded, or should I say hard-coded, into your files, which of course is not the best practice. But with applications such as SourceGuardian and using this within your applications, well, it's not really something you would have to worry about now, is it? Because nobody would be able to, you know, see what your code looks like. Okay, so this does come with a free 14-day trial, and you can check it out and use it. It is a pretty awesome platform, and starting it up, you will see that you have this interface. And with this, you can, you know, open a project, check out a load of videos. There's a lot of tutorials there as well, so it's definitely good to check those out. And at the same time, there is also a great deal of information within the SourceGuardian manual. Now, I would for sure recommend spending some time to go through this. I did that myself. I spent a few hours just going through, you know, first of all, just the GUI, how to use everything. And, you know, it's actually quite a lot to it. Now, as you start getting deeper into the documentation, you'll find that you can use it on just about any operating system, as well as, you know, protect just about any type of file, which is really cool, because not only your libraries, but even your documents, if you wanted to protect that, you can do so using the SourceGuardian project. Okay, so I am going to go through how to use this. So I'll skip some of these sections and I will make some highlights here. Now, I'm just going to come down to the bottom here because there are some important parts down here with the code and everything. You want to check these out and, you know, make sure you know what you're doing as you are actually encoding and decoding your data. Now, in general, within the application, it's pretty straightforward. And then within the application, you also have the option of downloading the library codes, which you can then basically import into your Scriptcase project and, as I was saying, on the fly encrypt and decrypt your data, which is pretty powerful, right? Okay, so I can keep scrolling here. I probably lost the page here, but as you see, you'll come into lots of information in here, and it's quite an extensive document. So you do for sure, as I said, want to take some time to have a look at this. You have all the information regarding the loaders and everything, and a loader is what we have also available here on the homepage of SourceGuardian. So just to run SourceGuardian, and I should really highlight the important fact here. Why am I even showing SourceGuardian? Well, we use SourceGuardian, Scriptcase, NetMake, we use SourceGuardian for protection of our own code and applications. And those are, of course, provided to you. And with that, you would then generally need to have a SourceGuardian loader enabled on your server. Now, when you install Scriptcase, everything comes as it is, But when you set this up on your own server, maybe you will need to make some adjustments. So you will want to check out your PHP ini file, which is what I'm looking at here. And of course, you need to scroll all the way down here. And you have the Zen load at the top there indicated. And there we have here the SourceGuardian. So this needs to be enabled. And of course, ideally the latest version. Now with that, you can then, of course, run the SourceGuardian applications, such as Scriptcase, which with that, then you can then develop your applications, code all you like, and of course, even integrate this into your own applications with your own license and protect your own code as well as Scriptcase's code, which is already protected, by the way, because of course, Scriptcase has a license for this. But you would then you need your own for your own project. Okay, so today what I'm going to be doing is I'm going to be encrypting my own website. So I have my Scriptcase by Jamie website here where I offer various things for Scriptcase to help you guys out. And what I've got then is, of course, all of my files here. So let me drag that up here. I have here all of my files for this. So this is a folder. If I decrease that a little bit, you see that is here in my WAMP folder, my WW folder, and here I place those files within a test folder. So that is here the index folder, the index file, and you see that there opening again, and there it is. If I just resize that, you kind of see that there, but you see that already within this browser here. Okay, so what we're going to do is basically encrypt my files. Now, just to have a quick look at those files, I have here my index page. And if I open that with here, say Notepad, and drag that down here into view, then here we'll see that I have a very typical HTML encoded page. Okay, so that is pretty much the code for my website. And of course, maybe I would want to protect that. And to do that, well, I could use here the SourceGuardian. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to copy my files here. Because each time I tried to encrypt the files here on my C drive, it didn't really like it very much. So I'll come here to my D drive and I'll create here a new folder. And let's call this my site or my platform or whatever. It doesn't really matter what we call the folder now. I'll paste my files in there. And there we go. Done and dusted. They are then now in here, and we can then go ahead and start to encrypt these applications. So now with the SourceGuardian open, I can then go ahead and choose here to create a new project. And then the project window will open. Now notice at the top right hand side here at the corner, we have all of the versions of PHP that are supported by SourceGuardian. And it really is pretty much all the versions that are supported today, so you have no problems using those. And of course, Scriptcase uses PHP 8.1, so we don't really need these earlier versions. We can get rid of these if we wanted to and just leave that from 7.4 maybe or 7.2, whatever you prefer, and just have support for those available. Okay, so what I'm going to do is then I'm going to add my files. So now I'll come here and click Add, and then I want to come here to my C drive. In fact, it was my computer because we placed them here onto my D drive and then my site here. And then here I have then all of my files. So I have my index here. So just to show you that once more, here is the site. Here we are in the site folder here. Here I have the index page. So if I open that again, we have that now opened over there again. So drag that here. There we go. That's the page. All right. Now I'm going to leave that open here, so hopefully it doesn't go and open a new window again. And now within SourceGuardian, what I can then do is then choose here the index page, add that. So I'm just going to encrypt that one page for now. And then I need to choose a destination folder. So what I'm going to do is then I'm going to come back up or maybe even in the same folder, and I'll create a new folder here and I'll say, call it output. And encrypted even. Okay, so I'll choose that folder, click the choose button, and now we have our destination set as well as the files, or we can have many files here. The type here is indicated as well as when it is modified last and so forth. So now I can click here the encode button. Now if I click that, off it goes, and it will encode my file. Now, that process I've just done with the secondary drive, you can also try on your C root, okay? But within some directories, I was really having problems with the encoding of the file. So this is more than likely an issue with SourceGuardian because, of course, I'm logged in as admin. I have rights in all these folders. It didn't make much sense, but maybe it's because it's the C drive. So just be wary of that one. Now, with that, I can then also go ahead and check my PHP info file. So I have here the location of my PHP info. And then if I come back here, I can paste that in there and it will go suggest me. And it goes details of your platform have been detected, VC library not detected. So I do not have no VC library there. Dynamic loading not possible. And the latest version of SourceGuardian is already installed on your system and is ready to run protected scripts. So there may be the odd, you know, error there, say not detected. It's not really an error, it's just information, okay? Of course, if you have them enabled, then awesome, that will for sure make it better for you. But of course, I'm running this on my local WAMP environment. So I can go ahead and close that and close that up. And then also, before I continue, go and show you the file, I wanna actually show you here the advanced options. Because within the advanced options, we have other settings that we can define here. For instance, we can change the error codes that are displayed, the header code, as well as, you know, how it's handled, the copyright and so forth. We can enable these short tags as well as strict errors and so forth. So all of those are possible here. And at the same time, we also have an extra feature here because, as I said, you are able to actually use this online. And by using this online, you would want to maybe lock it to an IP address or lock it to a domain or a specific server, even a MAC address, a machine ID. Yeah, the possibilities for this are awesome. So that this way your files, well, they will be locked to a MAC address or a specific machine ID. You cannot get really better encryption than that, okay? So this you only get with the full license, so I cannot actually download this license file, set this up within my libraries, and then of course show you how you would use this within Scriptcase, which is a bit of a shame, but I'm sure you can imagine, or you already know how to import libraries. So you export this, you import that library, and then you add your library into your file, just like you do any other library. And as I was saying, be sure to check out the SourceGuardian documentation. Okay, so let's have a quick look then here at our new file. So if I come here to our applications, and then here I have the output encrypted, and now I have here my index page. And if I open that up, it's opened up in the other tab again. We now have this encrypted. There we are. And there is our encrypted code. And that is the index page that I just had. Okay. And what we can actually do is, let's see if I can get this running, because during the live session, when I was running the webinar to just fly over this really, I didn't really get that working. It was not working. It was during the previous tests, but it was not then. So I'm going to place that here into my test folder. And if I just paste, it's going to replace the file in the destination. And then let's see here now, if I refresh here my page, if I now have an error. And there again, I have an error, of course, and more likely because I do not have, it says here, I install the loader. But even though it's telling me I have the loader installed already. But at the same time, this is my WAMP setup, and for sure, I would not be surprised if I need to make further adjustments in this to actually have this working properly with the SourceGuardian library directly. Of course, for Scriptcase, it works. So yeah, which is the part that I'm not fully understanding and would need some extra investigation maybe, or of course more time on the SourceGuardian documentation, because as I said, there's a lot of information. I probably went 40-50 pages in by the time I got to the live session, and I had skipped down here to some of the code sections to, you know, figure some of that out and see if I can add it into the libraries and so forth. But really, you have to have the license, you have to purchase actually the license with SourceGuardian. Well, that is pretty much it, I'm afraid. That's all I can show you for SourceGuardian, because of course, without the actual being able to download the actual applications and actually add them into Scriptcase, which would be the fun part. Now, I should again highlight the loaders here. Now, of course, we have the loaders available here. You can download those. You need to accept the terms and conditions as it just indicated, and you can download that then as a zip file, and then off it will go and download those files for you. Now, with those loader files installed, whether that be on your live server or even locally, you would then be able to decrypt these applications. But again, you only have that for a few days. You will want the license, and as you see here, it is $249 for you to protect that code that you have been working so hard on. And I can tell you, in many cases, you will want to do this because, as I said, you may have your keys hard-coded within your applications. And if you do, you do not want them visible within your code or identifiable. Okay, so with that, I would like to say thank you very much for joining today. And I hope you have, of course, enjoyed this video, and that with it, you maybe start to think about encoding your data and protecting it from everyone else. Okay, so thank you very much for watching, and until the next Scriptcase video.